Have you ever heard the word kime being used in karate? Maybe your instructor or some expert or sensei has said that your technique lacks kime, or that that girl needs more kime in her punches or blocks. Then this video is for you. Today I want to explain the meaning behind this Japanese term in karate, why it's important, and how you can develop your kime. Follow me. The word itself, kime, K-I-M-E, comes from the word kimeru, which in Japanese, for those of you who are interested, looks like this, kimeru, actually means to fix or to decide or set. In other words, kime is that split second moment of impact at the end of your techniques, when you lock them out, when you fix anything. It could be a punch, a strike, a kick, a block, even a stance can have kime. Now, why is this important? And that's a really good question, because some people think that karate is all about full contact, when in fact, it's about full control. You see, if you are able to stop any technique at any given time or moment, that means you have full control not over only your body, but also your mind. Because your body and mind are two sides of the same coin. Now, obviously, there are many interesting and different, sometimes even beautiful, interpretations of kime and how it should be applied in karate. But looking at a strict sports science perspective, kime is nothing but a short, isometric neuromuscular contraction given from an isotonic contraction. In other words, to put it more simply, you move and then you stop. Now, the question is, how can we develop this? Alright, so for this exercise, all you need is a ball. Just make sure that the ball fits in your hand, so it can't be like a football or anything. I have a super old school, worn out tennis ball. It even got some tape on it. You can use any type of foam ball or a golf ball, it's up to you. Now, here's what you do. Find a wall, or even better, a friend who can throw the ball to you. If you have a wall, you throw the ball against the wall. As it bounces back, I want you to catch it as fast as you can and lock out your arm with kime as you catch it. Did you see that? That is a way of developing your kime using your hand-eye coordination and a ball. Let me show you again. You can, of course, use different hands like I just did, and even have your passive hand at the hip like we have a lot in karate. You can do this exercise at different angles, different heights, different levels, even different stances. Like a sumo stance, a shikodachi, kibadachi, maybe even a cat stance, like this. In the end, it's up to you how you want to express your ability to develop kime using this exercise. And that's it for today. I hope this video helps you understand what kime is, why it's important, and now how you can develop it. The rest is just practice, 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 and practice. Did I mention practice? That's it for today, guys. Thanks for watching, and remember to visit my website, KarateByJesse.com, if you want to learn more, and please leave a comment to let me know what you thought. Until next time, train hard, good luck, and have fun.